If you're still debating between dental loupes and a microscope, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Siju Jacob. I've been using a surgical microscope in my private practice for more than 20 years, and I've also been training dentists how to use the surgical microscope in everyday clinical practice for more than a decade. Today, we are settling the loupes versus microscopes debate once and for all. I'll break down 8 different factors that you need to consider when comparing loupes with microscopes. Stick around till the end because I'm going to tell you when to use the surgical microscope and when to switch to your loupe. Let's start with the most obvious one, magnification. Loupes and microscopes are both used because they help us magnify what we are looking at. However, they're very different. With a loupe, you need to decide in advance what kind of magnification you're looking at. You need to figure out, do I need a 2.5x loupes? Do I need a 4x loupes? Do I need a 6x loupes? And so on. With microscope, it isn't like that. Microscopes offer a wide range of magnification, starting from as low as 2.5x and can go as high as 30x or even more than that sometimes. So with microscopes, you don't have to decide in advance what kind of magnification you want. You have the flexibility of switching between magnifications. This is very different from a loupe. If you want multiple magnification with a loupe, 9 times out of 10, you need to buy multiple loupes. You don't have to do that with microscopes. So that's the first factor you need to consider, and the microscope wins here. Now let's talk about the second factor, which is illumination. And this is where the microscope really shines and has a huge advantage over loupes. How does that happen? In order to use a loupe efficiently, we need some sort of external lighting, which is often attached independent of the lenses. The problem is the path that is traveled by the light is very different from the path that is traveled by the magnification. With microscope, it's very different. Microscopes have something known as coaxial illumination, which means the path of the magnification is same as the path of the illumination. So when you look through a microscope, magnification along with illumination is seen along the same path, and that makes all the difference, especially in deeper areas. There is absolutely no shadow when we use a surgical microscope. And this is the main advantage of using a microscope, because microscopes offer coaxial illumination, something which the loupes can never offer. So it is coaxial illumination which gives the microscope a huge advantage over loupes. Now let's talk about something that will absolutely save your career: ergonomics. Dentistry is a physically demanding profession, and dentists have a very high tendency to be physically injured. Why? Because dentistry puts you in all kinds of awkward positions which are repeated over a long period of time, resulting in physical injury. Loupes help you because they are better than working with a naked eye in minimizing the tendency to get injured, but the nature of loupes is such that no matter what you do, you have to do some degree of bending your neck or your back in order to perform treatment. With microscope, it's not like that. With proper guidance, like the kind of guidance that I offer, for example, in my online course, you can learn how to work extremely ergonomic with the surgical microscope and almost completely eliminate most of the physical injuries that dentists tend to get as they progress in their career. So when it comes to ergonomics, the kind of ergonomics that you can get with a surgical microscope, it's almost impossible to get that with even the most advanced loupes. So ergonomics is a huge advantage when it comes to surgical microscope compared to a loupe. Documentation. This is a massive advantage with surgical microscopes. If you want to do clinical documentation when you are using a loupe, you have to stop what you're doing. You have to examine the patient, take off your loupes, then bring in your macro photography setup or your intraoral camera, take pictures, then put the device aside, then go back to wearing your loupes and continue with whatever you're doing. So you need to take a break from what you're doing to document. And even after that, there are many other issues, but this very factor of not being able to do it simultaneously is what differentiates the microscope from a loupe. With microscopes, When you attach a camera to the surgical microscope, you can do what we call simultaneous documentation. You don't have to take a break from your procedure. You are observing something and you want to document. All you need to do is tell your assistant or give some sort of a sign to your assistant. The assistant just clicks a picture and then you go about doing your work. So you aren't taking any breaks from procedure. So it becomes really efficient and ergonomic to document using a surgical microscope. That's the first advantage. The second is the quality of pictures that you get and the quality of videos that you get when recording through a surgical microscope is way, way higher than what you would get if you're using a loupe along with your macro or your intraoral camera. So the quality of the pictures, again, is a huge advantage when you compare microscopes to loupe. And why do we say it's a huge business advantage? Because the number of conversions that you get when you document really well with a surgical microscope is significant. It's something that can offer practices a huge competitive advantage in the long term. What about the learning curve? Now, let's be honest. Microscopes do have a learning curve, and this is where the loupes have an advantage. The learning curve that you have with a loupe is far shorter than what you would have with a surgical microscope. However, what I've seen in my own experience and the experience of hundreds of students that I've trained, this so-called learning curve is upfront. It's only when you start using the microscope. As you get used to the microscope, it becomes much more easier. And remember, the payoffs that you get because of the effort that you put in to learning the microscope and incorporating it will pay you huge dividends over a period of time. So yes, there is a learning curve, but with the right guidance, for example, the online course that I offer, Microscopic Dentistry Simplified, you can get over this learning curve very fast and then reap the advantages that the microscope offers you. So learning curve, yes, easier with a loupe, but definitely worth overcoming with the surgical microscope so that you can gain all the benefits that are bound to come when you get used to the surgical microscope. Now let's address the elephant in the room, the cost. Yes, microscopes are definitely more expensive than loupes. So this is one factor that you need to consider. But remember, good loupes aren't that cheap either. So if you start doing your research and you start comparing an entry-level five-step microscope, which is what you need to get started, and compare that with a really high-end loupe, the difference might not be that much. So yes, on the face of it, it might seem like a lot, but you get down to the actual figures, you might be surprised as to how less a microscope actually costs. The second factor to consider when we talk about cost is a return on investment. What I've seen in my own experience in my private practice and the experience of hundreds of students that I've trained is that the amount of money that you invest in a surgical microscope, you will recover the investment in less than a year. Why? In terms of increased conversions, in terms of more referrals, in terms of how your practice is perceived as something offering premium services. So many different advantages over a period of time, and you tend to get back this investment in less than a year. So on the face of it, it might look like you have to invest a lot, but believe me, you will get back that investment in a very, very short period of time. Now, when do you use a microscope and when do you use a loupe when it comes to general dentistry procedures? Now, let's say you're someone who's already been using the loupe for a long period of time and you make this decision that you are buying a surgical microscope and bringing it into your general dentistry practice. Do you still need to go back to your loupe or can you do everything under the microscope? What we've seen is initially there is a learning curve, so you tend to go back to your loupe from time to time. But as you get used to the microscope, which is often a few weeks, and you get used to multiple procedures, most practitioners will reach a stage where you can do 95% of all your general dentistry work under a surgical microscope. The 5% of time that you still need a loupe is often with procedures where you need a larger field of view, not where you want to see more magnified. If your goal is to see it even more magnified, then the microscope will always outperform the loupe. Where you still need the loupe is at a very low magnification. In our private practice and in most of the students who got used to the microscope over a period of time, what we've seen is we still have a loupe which is usually 2.5x or 3.5x, and that's it. And we go back to that whenever we are performing a procedure where we need to take into consideration the surrounding areas as well. For example, a complex surgery. Such procedures, then yes, you will go back to your low-powered loupes, which is typically 2.5 or 3x. Other than that, you can do virtually everything else through the surgical microscope. So 95% of all your general dentistry work, you will reach a stage after a few weeks where you don't have to use the loupe. So that's how we switch between the two. You switch to the low-powered loupe only in certain procedures where you need a wider field of view, which is typically the lower back. So we've discussed most of these factors, but I saved the best for the last, because the major advantage when you compare loupes to microscopes is not in the procedures that you do or how you can go about doing things. I think the main difference is the differentiation. If we are talking about practitioners who are using a loupe, virtually every clinician these days is using a loupe, whereas if you talk about general dentists who use the surgical microscope, the number of general dental practices who are using the surgical microscope for everyday general dentistry is probably less than 1%. So if you put in this effort and you bring in a microscope into your general dentistry practice, it immediately puts your private practice way ahead over 99.9% of practices out there. So a lot of people overlook this particular factor, that is the ability to differentiate yourself in a very, very crowded market. That alone should be worth the time, effort, and the money that you're putting in to incorporate a surgical microscope into your dental practice. I hope what we've discussed today has helped in some way to simplify your understanding of the age-old debate of microscope versus loupes. If you'd like a free PDF which summarizes everything that we have discussed so far, then click on the link that appears in the description and I'll send you a completely free PDF which summarizes everything we talked about when comparing microscopes to dental loupes, and hopefully it will help you make an informed decision when you decide to buy a microscope. If you found the video useful, then do share it with your friends and don't forget to click subscribe so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. And I'll see you next week with another video.